नमस्कार, आई एम डॉक्टर अमित भारद्वाज। आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर इंडिया मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट डेली वेदर ब्रीफिंग फॉर टुडे 26th ऑफ अक्टूबर। नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट टुडेज हाईलाइट, द मेजर हाईलाइट इज दैट देर इज अ डीप डिप्रेशन ओवर साउथ ईस्ट बे ऑफ बंगाल एंड पॉसिबली फॉर इंटेंसिफिकेशन इन टू अ साइक्लोनिक स्टॉर्म ओवर साउथ वेस्ट एंड एडजॉइनिंग वेस्ट सेंट्रल बे ऑफ बंगाल बाय 27th ऑफ अक्टूबर। इट मे फर्दर इंटेंसिफाई इन टू अ सीवियर साइक्लोनिक स्टॉर्म ड्यूरिंग मॉर्निंग आवर्स ऑफ 28th ऑफ अक्टूबर। The another highlight is the deep depression over East Central Arabian Sea. So these are the major highlights, and due to that, there will be heavy to very heavy rainfall with isolated extremely heavy rainfall can occur over East Coast and West Coast of India. We'll be describing full details in multi-hazard warning graphics maps. Now, if you talk about past 24-hour weather observed, so heavy rainfall, heavy to very heavy rainfall has occurred or recorded over Gujarat region and Tamil Nadu region. And Gujarat region, one of the district received 16 cm of rainfall, and over Tamil Nadu, maximum 13 cm rainfall has been received. And isolated heavy rainfall over some of the district over West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Saurashtra, Chhattisgarh, Konkan Goa, Madhya Maharashtra, Coastal Karnataka, and Coastal Andhra Pradesh. So now if we talk about the major highlight of today, as you already know that yesterday, depression over Southeast Bay of Bengal intensify into a deep depression over Southeast Bay of Bengal in the morning hours of today, and it nearly moved northwestward with a speed of 6 km during past 6 hours, and currently lying over the same region. So its current latitude is near 11.2 and 87.1 degree east, 11.2 degree north, and longitude 87.1 degree east. So it is about 620 kilometer west of Port Blair and 780 kilometer east southeast of Chennai, and 830 kilometer south southeast to Visakhapatnam, 830 kilometer south southeast of Kakinada in Andhra Pradesh, and 930 kilometer south southeast of Gopalpur, Odisha. So this system is nearly likely to move west northwestward and further intensify into a cyclonic storm over the southwest and adjoining west central Bay of Bengal during next 24 hours. Thereafter, it is likely to move nearly northwestward, then northwestward, and intensify into a severe cyclonic storm by the morning hours of 28th of October. Continuing to move further into the north northwestward, it is likely to cross Andhra Pradesh coast between Machilipatnam and Kalingapatnam around Kakinada during evening or night of 28th of October as a severe cyclonic storm with maximum sustained wind of 90 to 100 km per hour, gusting to 110 kilometer per hour. So this is the major highlight. And if you talk about the Arabian Sea system, as you can see, the black line is showing the observed track, and the depression over East Central Arabian Sea moved nearly southwestward with a speed of 13 kilometer per hour during past 6 hours, and it lay center at 8:30 hours IST of today over the same region. If you talk about lateral location, so it is 16.0 degree north and longitude 66.5 degree east, which is about 760 kilometer west southwest of Mumbai, 790 kilometer west of Panjim, and 870 kilometer north west of Aminidiv, Lakshadweep Islands, and about 970 kilometer west northwestward over Mangalore. So this system is likely to move nearly southwestward initially and then south southwestward across East Central Arabian Sea during next 24 hours. So these are the major systems and major highlights about those. And there are for other systems, there is a trough. If we talk about the synoptic system, there is a trough in the upper air cyclonic circulation which is associated with the deep depression over East Central Arabian Sea to the west of west Madhya Pradesh across East Arabian Sea and South Gujarat region between 1.5 and 3.1 km above mean sea level. There is also a western disturbance which is a trough in the westerly the location is around 61 degree east to 28 degree north. So these are the synoptic system. Now if we talk about the multi-hazard warning map, as you can see that the orange color warning alert has been issued for Gujarat and Saurashtra region, where isolated heavy to very heavy rainfall is likely today, and also coastal Karnataka where orange color warning alert has been issued for today, very heavy rainfall warning. And in yellow color, the adjoining regions, you can see that where heavy rainfall warning alert has been issued for as a yellow color. And the other regions which you can see that isolated thunderstorm lightning with the gustiness can occur, which has been marked here in yellow region. And over Andaman Nicobar, as you can see that heavy rainfall warning with the thunderstorm and lightning alert has been issued, where the wind speed can reach 40 to 50, gusting to 60 kmph for today. Now if we talk about day 2, which is 27th of October, as you can already know that system is progressing from Bay of Bengal. The red color warning alert has been issued for coastal Andhra Pradesh for 27th, and you can see that west coast of India or from Odisha and the Tamil Nadu, Rayalaseema, Kerala, coastal Karnataka. These are the regions where heavy to very heavy rainfall is likely, and orange color warning alert has been issued. And if you talk about the west coast of India, specifically our Gujarat region and west Madhya Pradesh, isolated heavy to very heavy rainfall is likely over those regions. And the yellow color warning alert has been issued for isolated heavy and with isolated thunderstorm and lightning activity, where these orange yellow color mark has been issued for D2. Now if you talk about the system related, as you can see that system is coming close to the coastal Andhra Pradesh, and then on day 3, which is 28th of October, it is likely to be very close to the coast, and the red color warning alert has been issued for over coastal Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Chhattisgarh and Telangana region, and adjoining region you can see that Vidarbha, Rayalaseema and Tamil Nadu region, where heavy rainfall is likely due to that system. And yellow color warning alert, you can see that other regions where heavy rainfall warning with lightning thunderstorm activity has been given for day 3. Now if you talk about day 4, the orange red color warning with isolated extremely heavy rainfall warning alert has been issued for coastal Andhra Pradesh and Odisha, which will continue for day 4 also for 29th. For day 5, as you can see that only heavy rainfall warning alert has been issued for the east coast of India, considering also the northeast of India and adjoining regions with thunderstorm lightning activity as in yellow color mark. So day 6 and day 7, most of the system projected path is towards the northeast of India, therefore only heavy rainfall warning alert has been issued for day 6 and day 7 on northeast of India and adjoining regions of Gangetic West Bengal, Bihar and Jharkhand. So, and with isolated thunderstorm lightning activity also is being issued for day 6 and day 7 only over northeast of India. And if you talk about the fisherman warning graphics, as you can see that from day 1 to day 5, most part of the Bay of Bengal, which includes south, central and which are been marked here in the polygon regions, fishermen are advised not to venture in these region from day 1 to day 5. And the major intensity where the cyclone center is there, severe cyclonic storm is impact is there, the colored region are been also been highlighted where fishermen are advised not to venture. So that's all for today. For the detailed information, you can download the press release from IMD Mausam website, and you can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter to get the update information regarding this system. That's all for today. Namaskar. Dhanyawad.